Hey guys, today I'm gonna do a little tutorial for you on how I edit this picture without any presets and just Lightroom, no Photoshop, nothing else, just Lightroom. So hope you enjoy this. Let's put on some good tunes. John Lennon, that is what we like. Oh yeah. Okay, so here we go. So that's the picture. First thing I do is I check out the white balance for that. So first thing we do, we check out the white balance, how I like the colors. This one is a little bit blue, so we crack it up a little bit, get it more yellow there. And then how is it with the pink green? There we got a nice balance. So from here, I like my picture quite a bit overexposed. So I start by exposing the picture quite a bit. It looks a bit weird now, but you kind of figure out why I do this later. From here, I don't really do much more later. First, I go down to my curves, my tone curves, and I just start marking this by some points here. And then first thing I do, I like to drag down my highlights just to like kill them a little bit to make it more a vintage look. And then I grab down the shadows here and give them like a fading. This is a look you see a lot on Instagram, but it's not weird because it gives it like, it's not strange that so many people use it because it gives it a very natural look. Look, just the difference this does. It's not much, but it gives it like a very natural tone. Then I drag it more down here, so I get more shadows in my shot. And then just work with the tones and see. Really just see what it does to your picture and how you like it. I keep it up there. Starts looking really nice already. See the difference it's there? Great difference already, but you can play a lot with this. I think I even take it a bit more here. It's great. Yeah, you probably see that I edit with white in the background. That is for a reason, because when you have a white contrast, you can change that very easy here. Having white means you can see your white tones much better. Many people edit, this is the standard for Lightroom. Makes it very hard really to see your colors, so with white you see them a lot better. So I think I like the basic tones. It starts to become something. We can leave it there for now. Now I move up here. Start with clarity. This is a basic thing I always do. Taking down the clarity a bit gives it more a moody look. If you see here, this is like many photographers in Norway around, they work a lot with like high clarity and high saturation. This is like first edit style. Oh yeah, love this. Now, so I like to take down the clarity, give it more a moody look. Then we've done exposure, clarity, and we worked with a tone curve. Now we start to do the individual highlights and shadows. For example, I like always to take my highlights a little bit down to give it like a little faded look, but on the other side I take up my whites to make, the important for me is to, the background should be blurred out, kind of like bleached, so you gotta still take out the whites, but so you don't get this shine too much, you take down the highlights. Shadows, taking them a little bit down to get some texture. Same with the blacks. From here on, when I've done this, I often go back to my tone curve and work with that again. Do more, just again, how do I like my shadows? Do I want them a bit more bleached, faded away? So from here I kind of like skip back and forward a bit to give the picture the texture I want. starts to look really nice already. Actually, I think we started off a bit too light down there to 90. So now I kind of have done my basic toning with the light, and but now comes the, all the cool things you can do with light drums. First, I would start with my grayscale filters. I always use a lot of grayscale filters because it's kind of the post-processing you need to give the image the look you want. So first off, I like to start with the grayscale filter. Exactly, in a picture like this where you kind of like can split the picture in half. It's like, sorry. You see like above the line, you kind of have the background, and under the line, you kind of have the foreground. So you can pretty simple just like, and then we can just reset this. We can turn up or down. And as I like it more bleached, I like to have this a little bit up, not too much. And then somewhat with the blacks. But if you take out the blacks, you kind of like give a more bleached look to it. You see that? So have it there. I like to. The importance with editing picture is to always keep it simple, not too much. Like, the small changes make the difference. Once you make them too tough, it's very easy to see that this is like very much edited. You see, this gives like a nice texture to the image, but doesn't change it too much. Though I feel like we kind of miss a depth in the picture. There, it's too bleached all the way. So what I often do, I play with shadows to give my picture a texture, give my shot a texture. So let's take a brush. Let's start with the brush now. I can show you two ways to do this. Start with the brush and kind of like just make a shadow, you know? Kind of like just keep it natural, try to make it natural looking. You see, when you do this yourself, you're like, everyone's gonna see this, but actually it looks fabulous on pictures, and it's not easy to notice, it looks very natural. See, can I turn this off and on? It's kind of like, it gives the picture a lot more texture, but it's not too bad. Take a little bit away again. Another way to do this, if you don't like this way, sometimes I just use this. This is a very, very cool thing to do, which you can use a lot in masking. So you zoom in your picture, but then you zoom out again. So you kind of like, you have, this is, so you have kind of two zoom ways. Zoom out of the picture, so you have around the picture. Then you take a grayscale filter and you kind of like drag it over the picture, so you have a lot more. Now you see, within here, you can change. You can choose, let's just light it up so you see what I change. You can see, you can choose between changing inside or outside the ring. And what is cool, you gotta think more outside the image, because a round filter, a round mask kind of starts in the middle and then feathers it out to the ends, so you can create amazing effects with this. Let me show you one thing, for example. Okay, now we wanna work outside the box. And if I just take the shadows down here a little bit, look what this does to the image. You can even like take out more feathering. And you get like a really, really, really nice shadow, natural looking shadow down here. So that's a great way to work if you want to keep it natural but need more texture. Another thing you can do with this, just show you now, it's not sure I'm gonna use it, but for example, if I drag something outside here, let's do something like this. I often use this in portrait. Now it's not that good to use because it's gonna look a little bit strange, but I like to use this in portraits, like a light coming in. So you imagine the sun is outside here, but you still have a shine coming in. So now we want inside the mask, and we drag out the blacks like this and increase the light a bit, and you get this really cool shine. As I said, in this picture it's not gonna look too great because you kind of like have it in the middle of the picture and nothing coming out, but imagine there was a face here and you put this here, you have like a shine coming on the face. So yeah, I'm not gonna use that in this picture, keep it like this. So yeah, now we kind of worked with our masks to get the look of the image we want. Have a nice shine to it, looks moody but shiny at the same time, I like that. So now we kind of finished our job with the light. Now comes something I really like to work with, which is tone, no, color curving and individual color correcting. I don't do anything often with the saturation up here, I just go directly here, and instead of the RGB curves, which just works with the light and shadows, you go into the individual colors. And let's mark these like this, so you choose what you can do. Here you got the light part, the upper half section of the picture, and here is the lower section, so the shadows. And if you drag this up, you make the shadows more red or more blue green, which is the contour color, kind of like get. And here's the mid tones, and here's the upper tones, you see. And same for these others, like if you go to blue, you will have more blue tones in the highlights, or more yellow, which is like the counter tone. And I mean, this looks strange to you now, but here actually, here comes the great color toning for a great looking image. So you just I always like to divide them in four parts, and then you always work very, very carefully. I start with the reds and look at my highlights, focus on the highlights. How do I want my highlights looking? Well, they look pretty okay now, but I would like to let them be more, like a little bit more kind of like tropic blue. I like that in my picture. So you see, dragging it out here, you get more like this aqua blue. So drag it just slightly, that's not really much, but it makes a difference really. Then moving on to my blues, dragging out a bit of the, like this. I'm gonna start really to like the blues now. Let's see if we can change them. This is really, there is no science behind it. This is really just feeling. Like this. We haven't changed much, but you see, it makes a difference to tones. And now to the lower part, the shadows. I like to keep them more red. It's just a style I have, but to achieve that style, I'm not doing like a red here. I'm kind of like focusing on the hand and the cup to keep it natural. So just taking a little bit more green. And then in the greens, take out greens again. Do you get that logic? It's a bit hard to understand, but you take in the red section, you take out reds to make it more green, but in the green section, you take out greens as well, makes it get like a red but still natural looking tone to it all. I like that. Let's see how it fits in. So yeah, I like the tones for the picture now. Working with the color tones, that's great. Now comes a really cool part. This is my favorite, so I save it to the last because this is kind of like how to make the look of your image. You go to the color, to the HSL color toning, and instead of working with this where he's like, you have hue, which is changing the individual color. If you, for example, take blue, you can change that. It changed really just that color. And you have saturation, which is like the intensity of the color. And then you have luminance, which is how bright the color is gonna be. But instead of working like this, I normally do this, which is a very genius feature, which I just discovered about 2-3 weeks ago. Instead of working with this, I tap this one, and I can literally like work in every area of the picture, individual, how I want. So let's start with hue. I go up here and kind of tap the sky. Okay, how do I want my sky looking? Dragging up and down, the computer changed the tones who are involved. Do you see? It changed the blue, but also the aqua. So it changed the colors automatically that are involved. And so, yeah, I like my blues like this, like a little bit aqua-ish. But I still find them too much saturation, so I can take out the saturation and then taking up the luminance to make like this look I want of like a background faded out. Like this, perfect. Okay, let's change here. I don't like the colors yet of the green here, so we can like individual change this one. And as I said, I like a red toning, so not do it too much, but drag it down a bit. Oh, here, that is what I like. And then take out a bit saturation, or in. No, I would say like something really in the middle. Oh, what changed there? You can really work individually with this one. Yeah, as that's the last thing I want to show you. I could do it with a mask filter. I kind of want the lighthouse to be more in light, so I just tap luminance here and take the colors in front of the lighthouse and increase them. So I kind of have the shadow coming up here, going into a light, very nice change, and highlights the lighthouse, and in addition you get a nice flow between the shadows down here and the very light part up here, but still focusing on keeping this one in the center and not making this very stupid looking. So now I'm happy with how this looks. I would like a little bit more saturation in this part up here. What you gotta be careful about is like you can't really tap this and change it how you want, because as you see down here it always is also the same color as the hand, so you gotta be careful with that, how much you change it. If you really want to change something and you can't, you can always use a brush, taking the brush, change the color there and not change it there. But I like to just keep it natural, not change too much, and have like a nice intermediate. And often you can trick it a little bit by, okay, editing this one and then later going back here and editing this, because even though they seem similar in the color, they're still a bit different. So the computer kind of like, if you go down to this one and then change the other, you can change them both. But what you gotta be really careful about in these kind of features, like the hand is the focusing part. The hand is what, so the most important is that the hand looks natural. You can't really change the color of the hand to a crazy looking color, because the hand is what is in focus. But yeah, that's it. I'm happy with the colors. I made a great difference. You have like, you see the main difference are the masks I put down here. This huge mask I put around where I then made the shadows around. Yeah, that's it. That's original, and that's without any presets. You can do a lot of different, and obviously I forgot to sharpen my image. There you go. That's how I edit my shots. Hope you enjoyed. Please like, guys, and subscribe, and I hope we can do some more videos soon.
I'm just a jealous guy. I'm just a jealous guy.